and tomato fan. Today I want to show you how I'm making the tomato sauce. As you know, here on the farm we grow 35 varieties of tomatoes. So they are different colors. I've got pink, red, yellow, orange, black, red and black, and so on, so many colors. Today I'm using the yellow and orange tomatoes to make tomato sauce. And as you see, I've got here my tomatoes cut up in chunks, which is beautiful. They are so nice, such sweet tomatoes, and they give us such a nice tasty sauce. Then I've got a machine. It's not an expensive machine, it's quite cheap. Bought it from Lidl, I think, but it's doing the job. It's taking the pips and the skin out of tomatoes, give me this nice puree. As you see, if you come closer, such a nice puree. It's smashing all the tomatoes up, taking the pips away, taking the skin away, and it's basically pureeing the tomatoes. Then I'm gonna boil them down for a long time, not too long, normal, and reduce the puree and make it a nice thick tomato sauce. I'm not adding any salt, any sugar, or any other ingredients. It's pure tomatoes. Boil it down and reduce. Very nice, very tasty, because they are having their own taste, their own sweetness, and it's absolutely beautiful. Let me go through the machine a little bit and you can see. As you can see, my tomatoes are cut up in chunks, as I said, and I'm putting them now through the machine, so big enough to go through that cavity there. And I've got the pusher, which is pushing them down to go through the sieve there, you see. And then the pips and the skin comes out at the other end into a separate bowl, which I'm gonna put that on a compost heap, not using any of this, of course. And then I've got the nice sauce comes out, which will go in the big pan and boil it down to reduce it, and then put it in the jars. Oh, I even have a little daughter here come out to help. Thank you very much. She's looking around, what shall I do, what shall I get up to? Sorry. Now I started to boil the tomatoes. As you can see, already started. So I'm going to boil it for a few hours, then I'll show you what is next. Tomatoes, put them through the machine. As you see, I started boiling them. I've stopped them boiling last night after 2 hours, so I'm continuing today. I've been boiling for another hour today. As you can see, it's been reduced quite a lot. I've started from here and now it's about here, so it's gone down, it reduced, and it's quite thick, as you can see. It's nice consistency now, so I'm gonna jar it up. Gonna put this in the jars and preserve it. I'm not using any preservatives, as I said, only pure tomato juice, just tomatoes. And this is the orange ones.
and it's now the right consistency to go in the jars. So I'm gonna do that on the camera so you can see how I'm doing my tomato sauce. So I've got my jars ready. I've got enough jars here, I hope. If not, I've got some more after they've been sterilized, and I've got the lids ready as well, sterilized as well. Now I'm going to pour this while it's hot, while still boiling. I'm gonna pour this in the jars, put the lid on and turn them upside down. You're gonna see. They need to be hot.
And it's cold down in where they rise.
Sorry. That's hot. The jars need to be hot. That way, when I put the lid on, it creates like a vacuum, and that's why it stays for 1 year without any problems. Because I'm not using any preservatives whatsoever at all. I'm only pouring in the jar when it's piping hot, and then put the lid on. It's very good to create the vacuum and keep them sealed in. Basically, they like sealing themselves in, especially if I turn it upside down. Ooh, that's hot now. And it works very well for me. I'm gonna do another jar so you can see. I'm gonna put a glove on because it was quite hot when I'm handling the jars. Putting the sauce into the jar, jarring them up, and look at this, how nice it is. Very nice, beautiful color, as I said already, but I want to mention again because I am so much in love with this. It's very nice. I've used for 27 jars I've got out, and for the 27 jars I've used about 28 kilograms of tomatoes, because my pan, it's for 30 liters of whatever I put in it. So I've used about 28 kilograms of tomatoes to make 27 jars. Per each jar, it's approximately 1 kilogram of tomatoes, and I've got 400 grams of juice in a jar. So each jar takes about 1 kilogram of tomatoes to make this juice. I'm calling juice, but it's more like a sauce. It's nearly like a paste, not quite, but it's very nice and thick. And it's tomato sauce slash juice slash paste, basically. Comes out very nice, very sweet. You wouldn't think that it doesn't have any sugar whatsoever in there. They're so sweet, and that's because the tomatoes are so nice. They taste nice in first place, basically. And it's all grown by us, which I'm very proud to say that. I'm gonna mention, sorry, I'm not showing up, but I am proud to have this amount of varieties of tomatoes all tasting nice. I'm gonna make some more colors, of course. I'm gonna do another short video on other colors. But at the moment, this is it for today. I'm gonna say bye and thank you very much for watching. I hope you found this interesting. Thank you.